Hi, my name is Puka. Today, I'm presenting the survival history. Survival, why? Because this has been there before every single civilization we know today. Since the beginning of mankind in Africa, the Kemetic civilization is the foundation of everything human beings know today. Today, Africa is known as a place where people are running away from, while others make a million into the place. But in reality, Africa is Eden, is the paradise of Eden, is where God put himself to govern. Most of us are neither Christian, neither Muslim, neither whatsoever, but in our mind we share the same conscience. How many people know about Adam and Eve? Most of us. But before Adam and Eve, people, the Kemetic people, did not believe in Adam and Eve. They believed in the ancestors who were spiritual, where they came from. Every single trouble they were having on earth, they were consulting their ancestor, meaning God and all the team that has created them. Because the Western society derived from the darker people, from the Kemetic people, the Africans. So they designed the African being the ancestor, Adam and Eve, which is rightfully so. It's right for them to have another man, Eve, which is the representation of the African, the Kemetic people, or the monkey, because they went to the forest and the monkey was juggling and the monkey was dark. So they said, no, they're coming from the monkey. So when they cross the ocean, they become human. Yeah, it's still no too different from Adam and Eve. But the monkey or Adam and Eve, when the monkey is turning, it doesn't look for another one to be his father. His father is the spirit where it came from. So why? Most of the people in Africa, they are spiritual. Why? Because they're looking upward, they're looking for the father. But most of the people in the Western world, they're looking for other humans to be the light. And it makes sense. It makes sense to have a pope here, it makes sense to have priests and all the other people here. But it does not make sense in the Kemetic land in Africa to have people to worship. No. In Africa, you have the spirit to worship because you know it's where you come from. So Africa, the knowledge of Africa in the time of the Kemet power, that knowledge has been attributed to the alien, rightfully so. Why? Because they didn't learn from human. Like people do today. We learn from our ancestor. We learn from the mystical realm. We learn from above. We learn from the horoscope come from above. It's inscribed in heaven. The history of Egypt in Africa and Ethiopia and Sudan and all over Africa is spread over the heavens. It's not spread over the earth. We don't look to human for advice. We look to the spirit. We look to where everything before happening on earth is already designed. When in the time, thousands of years ago, the African philosophy was around the sound, around the sun, and Aaron the sign of animals. Why? Because creation, in creation, everything has its true value and meanings. So when the tambourine is giving the sound from the tambourine create a vibration, because the message, the traditional message sent from village to message, from village to message to village, it was like the phone call. When somebody passed away, there is a rhythm to beat so that the person will get the message. So the vibration from the beat, from the sound, when come to traditional ceremony, was directly connected with the creator of all things, because spirit is a sound. When people talk about atom, the smaller this and that, those things have been known from the beginning. So the African, they knew how to harmonize the chakra, they harmonize the human body. To harmonize the human body, you need to bring it into movement. When a human is moving, it's directing energy. What I'm doing now, I'm moving the energy, because the energy is all around me. So, in the forever knowledge of the African, when you see them dancing too much, because dancing is the quickest way to establish peace and harmony in you. Why? Because it's moving all the energy around you. And once you hear the beats and the sound, and you start moving in the rhythm of that sound, you're bringing in you the perfect harmony. You take the sound, you put it in you, and you become that harmony. So they move those Kemetic African knowledge from being people who were dancing to bring harmony with themselves all the time to become worshiper. When you are a worshiper, you're losing your humanity. You're looking on another person to give you life, to give you what you are already. So they said in Egypt people were worshiping the sun, but this sun that is in fact the light of all humanity, the Western civilization took the sun and put it into a human on the cross, and the human became the sun, the human become the light of the world, this human become the sun that walk on the water. Just replace the true sun to this human, you will find out you just worship the same sun the African have worshipped, because it's this sun that gives life in everything on earth. Now they took those dancers to become a worshipper. So they're worshipping an entire race. Into that race, you know the pop. If you bow down in front of a human, you're losing your own humanity. You bow down in front of Mary, if you got the father, the mother, and the son, you already worship an entire race. But what has happened to the Kemetic people, to the Africans, when they took them from the traditional dance, they put them into the church, even into that church, they keep on dancing. Pata, 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 and people don't understand. It's because they're carrying on with the blood and flesh of their ancestor. And the blood and flesh of the ancestor has been harmonizing itself through the sound. It's a perfect knowledge. Now, here, there is a difference between believing and knowing. If I start saying, I believe this is my hand, I believe this is my hand, but that doesn't look quite right. Of course it's my hand. But if I said, I know this is my hand, it makes sense. Why? Because my hand is the evidence that is mine. So I don't need to believe when I have the evidence. So belief is where there is no evidence. Belief is based on a story. So why the Bible is the greatest story never told? It's not a greatest truth. And the, attached to it, God said it's the word of God. But God is not a writer. Animals have been reproducing themselves for thousands of years. They don't read any book. Why you, who is supposed to be created in God's image, do you need to read a book? Give that to the bird, because they're not God's image. So they will read the book to know how to multiply themselves or how to feed themselves. But I can assure you, they never read your book. And for thousands of years, they have been multiplying themselves. They never launched any war. They are existing according to the natural law set in the universe. So I'm introducing you to those natural law. In the beginning, when God created the African, He put in them His knowledge. He placed them in the Garden of Eden, the only land every human have been fancying for thousands and thousands of years. But that land have been given to the Kemetic people, to the African. Into that land they call them savage and all sorts of things. But they keep on rising in the mighty way of the Creator, just like the sun. Because the sun gives life, and the sun also gives the wealth into the land. It doesn't give life to human. It gives life even to the gold, to the wool, to the manganese, to the precious stone. You find them in Africa on the road. If you walk on the road, you can just kick a lion, you can kick an elephant, you can kick a gold, you can kick a diamond, you can kick everything. So blessed! You can understand why everyone want to. No, don't want to see an African, but they want to be in Africa. They want to take land over there for thousands of years. They never stop. You see the African running away from the continent. It's because everyone else wants to be over there to take all the goods. So blessed. Huh. Now, here is a mummy, meaning the source of knowledge. There are different kind of knowledge, but a human that is out of his humanity, out of his natural humanity, is that believer that will deny evidence. Thousands of years we have the evidence of plane in Egypt, and evidence is the only thing in court that gives you the right to claim your cases. No one can deny the evidence. This is another symbol of flight. It's a big story, I cannot go into all of it. This is the symbol of eternity, the fourth stage of eternity, the judgment, the balance, the sin, good versus evil. This is the symbol of the sky, everything in the sky, because people have been saying Egyptian was worshiping African, the Kemetic. People have been worshiping animals. No, everything created has a signification. The owl, which is here, is the symbol of the universe, the two big black holes in the universe. You can look at it online or in any other documentary you will find around you. The light, for thousands of years, the light was there. There are some small insects, they're giving light in the back. Everything gives light. This is the bullying, all those instruments. This is the sound of eternity. And here, you got the surgery tools. This is the evidence. It's not something to deny. You got the third eye that is on the dollar. It's originated in Africa. No one can deny it. This is the Sphinx, and you got the Louvre, all those pyramids. The European planification of society, everything comes from the African knowledge. Even the book people call the Bible, everything, the evidence of the Bible are in Egypt. The Bible itself have been written from Egypt. The masonry, all those things, this is horoscope. Because the African, they're looking up, they are spiritual. It's where they took everything. The 12 disciples, this everything is horoscope. But there is something amazing that is happening, is that the people, they think those signs and knowledge has been put there for design. No. When you see a bird with a feather, it pick up one feather, goes by. He leave the feather somewhere. He come back with another feather, pass, put it somewhere. Now he take a needle or something, he put it there. But what that bird is doing? No, the bird is building his nest. The bird is preparing the birth of her family. But you say what the bird is doing? So you, the Kemet people, the African people, what do you think when you're looking at all those sphinx and all those pyramids? Why do you think they were put there? Why? Do you really think people who put all this knowledge, the Western world has created an entire study called Egyptology? They have made billions of scientists, billions of professors to understand what they never managed to understand. But you're there sleeping. What do you think all this have been designed for? Brother, it has been designed for you. Your ancestor knew what is in a human. What is in a human is a spirit. It's a word. There is nothing else in the human. A spirit is the breath, is the word. So this is the shell. This is not you. This is your shell where you dwell. So your ancestor knew that if they take you down because of your love, you didn't have the desire to destroy the children you give, because every rest comes from you. But because of when something is diluted, it does not have the full capacity. It does not have the full power. So your ancestor knew that if they do not eternalize the true knowledge, you will never be able to stand up again. Why? Because you are the word, because you are the breath, which is the spirit. If they move it, if they remove it from the roots, you will need the evidence to brighten your mind. Effectively, they remove you from the root. They took off your culture. They changed your name. They changed your language. They changed everything for you not to become again. But you have the evidence to put you back in your position as a creator. You are the salt of this earth. Why do you think every civilization, to establish themselves, they have to come into your land, into Africa, into the Garden of Eden? Why do you think the Chinese are coming back with slavery? Stand up! Stand up! You are a believer. Belief is based on a story. So why they gave you the greatest lie story ever told, and they attach the name of God in it because they know you're spiritual? But for more than 50 years, that greater story has not changed your situation. Neither the one who give that to you. They don't reflect what is in there. If you go in Africa, in Sudan, in Ethiopia, and all those places in South Africa, you will find evidence of yourself, the reflection of your image. But if you go in Israel, which is, it was in Africa at that time, everywhere you will go, you are not going to find the evidence of your greatest story ever told. There is no evidence. They're finding scripture, they're manufacturing thing, manufacturing tomb for tourism thing, saying, oh, this is that, it doesn't exist. Your book has been written in Africa, and all the evidence of Solomon and whatsoever you find into that book are found in Africa. Your book has been imposed to the Westerner by a king, and some other king changed, refused. They rejected from Rome and they create their own authorization book. But you can also change the same book. King Henry, an English king, changed the book because the Pope didn't want him to marry the sixth wife. He changed the book. So you too can change the book. You can remove all those fake things that a human being is flying. They add that later when they said a human being is flying, a human being is the light of the world. No, it's the sun which is the light of the world, not a human being. And that sun, they make you worshiping other human. You worship Mary, you worship the Pope, you worship Jesus, you worship already a race. There is no way out. If you bow down in front of a human, how can a human say, how can you believe in the Son of God that call you sheep? He doesn't call you human. He said, my sheep, listen to me. My sheep, follow me. You are not a sheep. You are created in God's image. Since you walk out there, have you ever seen a representation of God? Is it not in you? For thousands of years, there is no other representation of God. God is the breath. God is the energy that is created by His firstborn, the Son. The darkness is His dwelling. The darkness is forever. The darkness is the representation of God. So why no one can see Him? In the deep darkness, you cannot see your finger. It's the fullness of everything. But you have been believing in the wrong philosophy, because for the Western philosophy to establish itself, it was supposed to destroy yours. The Chinese cannot become a civilization until they step in the European civilization. For thousands of years, that's how life on Earth is. For the Chinese to establish themselves, they have to differentiate their style with the European. So why they don't invite country? They got another style. They have to make the difference. But until they wipe out every belief of the European, they cannot establish themselves. And you, until you tear down every belief of the European, you cannot establish yourself. You cannot come back as a human. You need to change everything the Westerner has put in you. Because a human that is already call you black and call everything but black is a condemnation. So you need to come back into you and prove to that human that black is God, that you are not black, you are brown. A person that want to become black is an insult to God, because God is black. God is the fullness of everything. Just burn the old world, it go back to the source, to the beginning. Everything derived from black. If the African were not the first human on earth, if they never be, because there is no other race that can give birth to a brown human, it doesn't exist. If you put two Chinese, you will never have a brown human. If you put two European, you will never have a black human. If you just take them anywhere you want, you will never have the gold, the chocolate. But if you put your chocolate somewhere, you will have the albino. It's the proof of the European. you take that habano, you mix with another one, you got a Finlanders, you got a French, you got whatever you want to. And now if you take the child of the French and your son and you put them together, you may have an Indian or a Chinese. And if you take that, God is so wise, he put you there first. And from you, all the other living women are there. You don't need to check it. It is written. You need to go back to the original scripture. You need to go back to the evidence. This is what the Western have used to establish the civilization. They just swap the name and change everything. And they put their Pythagore, this name and this name and this name. And they came back in the 17th century and they become all of them scientists, creator of life, creator of everything that have been existing for thousands of years. But in one century, they become everything. They close up Asia, they took up everything over there. You can check the evidence. And now they don't hide it because they already done it anyway. Surgery. Everything was done. The light, everything was discovered. The eternity, everything has been done. And more than what you believe. Because in fact, a human on earth is here for experience. If you want to be a human, you need to dwell in truth and harmony. For any other person to take you out of your humanity, it just need to change the role, give you his name, give you his language, give you his education, and you already change. So you will live a life, people mocking at you, people looking down on you, you say, why are they doing that? They know why they're doing that, because they change you. They change you. You are like a lion that live with dogs and does not know it's a lion. Can you imagine? Since they have destroyed you, every continent has a weapon of mass destruction. You haven't got one. Why? Because they ask you to forgive. Forgiveness is not natural. There is no law that forgives sin. If you cut the hand is cut. If you kill a family, the family is killed. And so many things I cannot go through today. But if you go back to the evidence of life, they will show you the balance of life. But the fact is, it doesn't matter what human will do to you, because you are the salt of the earth, because you come directly from God. That is the first reason why people hate you, because you are the real image of God on earth. Everything any human will do will be good, because you are all human. Don't get me wrong, I love all human, because I'm a grandfather, a great-grandfather, a great-great-great, we are the creator of life on earth. Every race we see that they're coming from us. So we have that duty, at least to be the only one to be capable to love all the other. But everything we do is different than all the other. Greatness has been put in us. Greatness of humanity. We have been made for gold. If you put gold on brown, it's shining. If you put gold on other color, it shines best of brown. Your presence is important. Every field you put yourself in, you do far more than all the other. It's not only in sport. Oh, please, no. Most of the scientific research that you have done have been hidden from you. Like the heating, the light, most of them have been taken away from you to keep you like you are. But I'm giving you the secret. Your ancestors did not write this for nothing. It was the evidence that you will always remind yourself who you are. This is fun in Africa. Don't listen to people who are saying, oh, it's not from you, it's from the how do they call those extraterrestrial people who came on earth to establish? No, it's in Africa. And it's not only in Egypt, it's in Ethiopia, it's in Sudan. Sudan has more pyramids than Egypt. is all over Africa, and the Egyptian philosophy is still very well alive in your midst, but you don't understand it. All the tragic practitioners, they're consulting the stars to give you answer of your future. It's the continuity of this civilization. But you need to come back into yourself, because you are dying and the world is dying. The lack of compassion, the lack of love, the lack of understanding. Because as long as any human is mocking at you, is sharing the same pain, but full of ignorance. The world is full of professors, but those professors are just made from paper. Harmony and life is what makes things to grow, to fulfill, to be good. It's not you. A human cannot become by mocking at on another. A human cannot establish himself by killing another. It's not a reality. So everything is to be done. There is nothing like third world, first world war. No, it doesn't exist. Otherwise, China will be the heaven world, because they're on top today. No one is late. In a family, when you got seven children, one will have his A level before the other. But when they will grow old, they will be all. When they are young, they're all young. Everything that is happening all over the world is happening simultaneously. But nothing can be happening just like pop, pop, pop. No, one have to go first and the other one is coming and the other one is coming. That's how life is. So you can transcend all those things and make human to come back again, because you hold the key. You hold every single keys that have been given to human have been given to you. Until you level up. Level until you level up and you take back your position, there will be no peace on earth. It cannot be any peace on earth if the African has still mocked, because we share the same mind. It will never happen. For harmony to be established, we need a balance in everything. It's not the job of order. It's not an European job. Their job was to mess up. It's your job to stand up. A person who mess up just know how to mess up. It doesn't know how to stand up. It doesn't know how to fix. No, it's impossible. When a man breaks a computer, you need an engineer to come and fix it. So those who have been messing up around the world, despise their wealth, they keep on messing up. That means they will never know how to bring peace, because you can mess up because you want to be wealthy. Once you're wealthy, are you going to carry on messing up? But if a person carry on destroying all the other to remain the only one by messing up, that person will never bring you peace. A bad tree cannot produce good fruit. When you look at this kind of painting, go deep into the knowledge. Go back, because knowledge is backward. Forward is destruction. Forward is death. If you want to know, turn and go back. Those evidence have been put there for you. Stop being a believer. When you are a believer, you believe in a story. You believe in ignorance, because you believe because you lack of evidence. I'm presenting to you today your evidence. Don't call them ancient. What is ancient cannot exist today. What exists today creates a vibration. Everything you see around you affects you, directly or indirectly. Stand up for your continent. Stand up for yourself. I can assure you, if you don't love yourself, you will never be able to love another. If you don't know yourself, you will never be able to know another. Don't believe in those who are coming and say to you, love your neighbor as yourself. It's how the world lives today. Love your neighbor as yourself. That is how the world is living today. So why we live in chaos? I'm going to give you a new commandment. Know thyself. Discover yourself. Then you will be able to discover other. Do unto other what you will love them to do unto you. This commandment is a kemetic commandment. It's what was in the beginning before people took and changed thinking they're doing something better. Go back. to your knowledge. God will know the coming back on earth. He is everything you see. Stand up to discover yourself. It's not what people have done to you, but it's how much you know about you. When you discover yourself, you're shining like that light, and no one can overcome you. But when you are a believer, you believe in a human. When you worship a human, you worship a race. And if you believe, your life cannot change. If you believe you will go in heaven, you're missing your heaven here now. Because once you died, you will be buried. No one ever died and went into heaven. There is no evidence. If you want the evidence, go back to your ancestors. The mummy is the only evidence that they have been in life. No one ever flew to heaven. It will never happen. We are here for thousands of years. Once you die, your spirit go back where it belongs. If you don't know what is spirit, just think of your dream. That is the real you. Stand up today and start discovering who you are. Live like the animal. They live in perfect harmony with nature. Don't follow a human philosophy. If you see two people doing the same thing, they are victim of a philosophy. You are a world. You are not your face. If you believe in a world, you will die not experiencing your life. If you believe in yourself, you will find your own world, which is your ID, which is your individuality, which is your uniqueness, which is your vibration, and then you will be the world.